Sir, can we safely say now na ligtas na po siya sa death row? Kanyang pag-uwi.
Okay, nothing is 100%, no? Pero the fact that Indonesia is talking to us about transferring is the most powerful indication that they have no intent to execute her. Uh-huh. And obviously, once she's here, she is completely ligtas. Even if she remain in Indonesia, and we hope to have success in our negotiations, no? Even if she remains there, when we reach January 1, 2026, she'll be safe also with death penalty, but because of the Indonesian law. But let's not talk about that. Let's talk about her being here as soon as possible. But we can say, for all intents and purposes, she's safe. She will most likely not be executed. But the Indonesians are saying that she is still serving sentence. That has to be clear.
Right. Kay Asik Clavano po, nabanggit niyo yung kasong pending sa Nueva Ecija RTC. At isa yun sa dahilan, sabi niyo po, kaya na-delay yung kanyang execution before. May haharapin pa rin pong kaso si Mary Jane dito sa Philippine Court.
Well, the case that she faced was that one in Indonesia for drug trafficking. The case here, ano lang po siya, testigo lang po siya. Kaya natin ginamit yon bilang isang negotiating piece, bilang strategy din, legal strategy, para patagalin yung execution ho niya. At gumana naman ho. No? So pagdating ho niya dito, she will be serving the sentence that was meted in Indonesia. So itutuloy lang po niya yung sentensya niya. And I think it's worth emphasizing also that the most important aspect of this all is the difference in our laws. No? There, they allowed the death penalty. Dito ho, alam naman ho natin lahat na abolished po. So wala ho tayong death sentence dito.
Hindi na po ba siya ibabalik sa Indonesia? She will stay here na talaga?
That will be the lead when she's transferred. Yun na yun. And that will be not just for Mary Jane, but for the other aliens, foreign nationals that they may detain. But I would like, if possible, DJ to clarify, because baka tanong niyo, if she did not commit a crime in the Philippines, what would be the basis without the treaty, without a treaty with Indonesia on transfer sentence persons, what would be the basis that we would detain her upon on the basis of this agreement? By the way, when we detain her, it's not, yes, but we're still going to work on the clemency. Yeah? Now, Indonesia has given nice indications that they're open to it, but please.
Thank you for the opportunity, Yusek. It's the first time I'm being asked by a fellow panelist, but...
Yes. I want to be educated myself. Yes. Yes, yes.
Well, in this certain scenario, even without a treaty, there is no prohibition between... for countries to dialogue with each other and come into mutual agreement. On top of that, there is also a mutual legal assistance treaty between ASEAN countries where there is a widespread sharing of information when it comes to the criminal justice system. So that includes investigation, prosecution, and even post-conviction activities such as where they will serve their sentence. So this really does speak to the relationship between the two countries, the Philippines and Indonesia. Kaya natin nakuha ito dahil maganda po ang relasyon ng dalawang bansa.
Okay. Wait, last question lang po. Backgrounder, meron pa po ba tayong mga ibang OFW na nasa death row sa Indonesia? Hindi ko kaya maging way din to para sila ay umasa rin na baka mailigtas ng ating government.
Si Mary Jane lang po sa Indonesia. At mabuti po. Mayroon sa ibang bansa, of course, we're also doing everything we can. There are 59 worldwide. Mm-hmm. We're doing everything we can for them. As you know, this has long been a policy since 1995, and especially now under the government of President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., nagpupursige tayo po.
Okay. Jean Mangaluz, Philippine Star.
Hi, sir. Just to clarify, we're still undergoing talks for her release, so hindi final na uwi siya.
There must be a reason for the president to be this confident. If you mean may written agreement, wala pa yung sagot. Pero sila mismo ang unang pumunta sa atin to talk about this. So we're extremely confident it will happen. And certainly our president must be privy of information, which would explain his confidence. So let's just say that we're just going to fine-tune the details. Alam ng Indonesia, and I'd like to take advantage of this opportunity, we're assuring them we're not indicating that she's being released. That we're not saying, the president did not say she's free, but that she's coming home. And that we'll be respecting the final agreements between both countries on her detention, and anything about her liberation will have to be discussed pa.
How many years will she be detained here if itutuloy yung detention niya?
That is what we're going to discuss. Hopefully, not even 1 year. Pero, of course, bottom line, at least nandito siya, no? I mean, life imprisonment. Well, we can tell you, under Philippine law, wala tayong death penalty. But even when they say life imprisonment, nobody really stays up to life. This is not like the U.S. or Anglo system where you could be, depending on the number of crimes you commit, you could actually face a sentence of 180 years. Mm-hmm. Nobody's going to serve 180 years in jail. And many of them do die in jail. Many Philippines, after maximum 40 years, come. And then there's also the age, I think. After a certain age, hindi na dapat nakakulong. Is that still...
Well, it's more of internal policy for corrections.
Yes. So we don't foresee that happening. Indonesia has been very gracious, and I don't want to put words in their mouth, but there must be a reason that they are interested in the transfer to us. And I'm pretty sure they know that we are interested in their liberation, in their being set free. So, basta wala ng death penalty, and we'll continue working until she's free.
Okay, next question, Harley Valbuena, DZME.
Hi, good afternoon. Sir, do we think that the expected return of Mary Jane Veloso will expedite or will strengthen the local case here in the Philippines?
Well, it's very convenient for us to have a witness at the disposal of the prosecution. The reason why this case has taken so long is precisely because the chance or the opportunities to interview or take her testimony has been very scarce. It would entail a lot of costs, a whole team to be in Indonesia, including the judge herself. So whenever we take her testimony via deposition, the Indonesian government does require a whole team, including the judge and the prosecutors, to be there as well. So given the workload of all these government officials and the schedules of the families, it's quite difficult to come up with a common schedule. So having her here in the Philippines would be quite convenient and would definitely speed up the process of the case.
Once she returns, sir, we will be expecting that she will be physically present in the next court proceedings of the case.
Well, that will, again, the DOJ can request that the person of Mary Jane Veloso be brought to the court, but ultimately the court has to order, has to come out with an order, issue an order to CIW or any other facility where she will be staying to allow her transfer or temporary transfer to the court for the hearing.
I'd like to add to what Asik Lavado said. Indonesians were putting a lot of requirements for the deposition. In fact, if I got it right, they even wanted to also be part of the deposition.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, that was my translation. So it was kind of very complicated to do that. But here, pag nandito, there will be processes that will hopefully allow her to testify personally or at least... provider statement before the court.
Thank you. Ivan Myrina, GMA7.
Yusek, Asek, naturally the family of Mary Jane are very happy about this development. At ang panganawagan nila sa Pangulo, baka naman pwedeng wag na natin ikulong. Idiretso nyo na sa bahay namin para makasama na namin.
Alam namin
this is the same call by the private lawyer Attorney Olalia, that the president accord her immediate clemency. Is that even a possibility?
Well, I don't want to say that that something is impossible, but part of the deal is that we are going to respect Indonesian law. So I just don't see for now that she'll be flown home and then suddenly we let her free. In fact, you know, right now she's not yet here, so. Can I ask, we've already, the TFA has already said this in our statement, can I ask you and the Philippine Nation to join us in the hope and prayers that this will be successful completely and that you'll be home. And then, kung hindi right away, as soon as possible, mapalaya na. But the first day, no, that's, honestly, that's not very realistic, no? Hindi po. But, of course, that's a hope, but, kasi kung ganun po, parang, that's not a transfer. They will have officially acquitted her or released her. That's not what they promised. So, you know, Pop.
Understood. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Marie Carr, Sargon, Brigada FM.
Sir, clarification lang po kung may favor po ba na hiningi ang Indonesia in return. And sa binanggit po ninyo kaninang 59, merong 59 na nasa death row worldwide. Lahat po ba sila OFW, sir?
Yes, the first one, well, you must madali muna yung pangalawa. Filipinos, not all are contract workers, if you mean that, no? For example, we have quite a few in Malaysia who are on the death row because they were part of the invasion. I don't want to use the word invasion when I mention Filipinos entering Sabah, but they were part of the forces which entered Sabah and engage in military activities against Malaysian authorities. So they're not clearly OFWs. However, lahat yan, binibigyan ng protection ng pamahalaan, lawyers. Some of these cases are still under appeal. Niaramdam ko, sometimes may na-execute. You are aware of, even just this year, there have been a handful executed in China, for example, for drug offenses, or in Saudi Arabia. But every single one is being attended to. One positive news, a piece of news, is that there is now a worldwide trend for the abolition of the death penalty, or its de facto, I'm looking for the word, non-implementation, even in Malaysia. So that's one positive piece of news, no? So going about 59. Again, I repeat, Indonesia, none. The first question, aside from Veloso, no? The first question, no, I mentioned it earlier, they have not asked for quid pro quo or anything, prisoner exchange, nothing, po. Remember, they've always been gracious to us. Recently, they helped us with the Alice Guo case, no? So this is a good sign of what we expect under the new presidency in Indonesia, President Prabowo, and his dear friendship with President Bongbong Marcos. They haven't asked for anything. But, of course, in the future, if they may, then certainly the Philippines will remember this gesture on the part of Indonesia for our kababayan.
Okay. Annalyn Saburano. Bamborajo.
Sir, good afternoon. Sir, anong pong magiging proseso pag okay na po si Veloso, ibabalik na po siya sa bansa, sino po ang susundo sa kanya at pagdating po dito, saan po siya idedirect?
Well, first of all, probably will first there has to be a team to banggit kanina to discuss informally with Indonesia, formally yung plano. And then eventually there'll have to be a team, DOJ, DFA will have to be there. As for saan na banggit, but I'll ask to repeat what repeat the answer you gave about saan na kukuha. Kusan? Hindi pa final kusan.
So yeah, pinapag-usapan pa po ng DOJ officials. However, one of the obvious choices would be the CIW, Correctional Institute for Women in Mandaluyong.
Hindi po NBI, sir.
NBI po yung inatasan ni Secretary para sumundo. Para po ligtas po si
NBI, okay.
Sa Mary Jane Veloso. Of course, in coordination with the DFA as well.
Okay. Alvin Baltasar, Radyo Pilipinas.
Ambassador, congratulations sa appointment, sa promotion.
By the way, we will still see each other. It takes several months to finalize the process. By the way, you're congratulating. Hindi pa ako nakoconfirm ng commission appointments. Baka magalit yung senator sa mga senatorsan. So the current ambassador, and we salute her, her name is Junifer Mahilom West. She will be officially retiring on June the 3rd. So it will be after that, maybe end of June, early July. And I'll be there. So you'll still see me around. Oh. Let's finish Mary Jane Veloso first.
Yun nga yung segue ko na, Yusek. Doon sa usapin ng transfer po, Yusek, ano ba talaga magiging status ni Mary Jane Veloso? Parang a detainee of Indonesian government under the custody of the Philippine government.
That sounds good, but let's ask the expert lawyer.
Well, perhaps in more technical terms, the legal custody would be Indonesia's because we are asked to respect their laws and jurisprudence, but the physical custody will be with the Philippines. Yes. However, the Indonesian government is aware that we do not have the death penalty here, which they respect as well, which was a consideration, obviously, when they also issued the policy of transferring certain detained individuals back to their home countries. They are aware that not all legal frameworks are the same. They are aware that we have no death penalty here, and yet they are still in, they have still agreed to looking into the transfer.
So, Asik, may jurisdiction pa rin talaga ang Indonesian government kay Mary Jane Veloso?
In a way, because of their legal custody. However, it seems as though after she is transferred here, it is our legal framework that will be put in place.
Mm-hmm. I will add to that. The word I was looking for kanina, moratorium. There is a strengthening worldwide trend for a non-imposition or a moratorium on the imposition of death penalty. Now, where does that relate to Indonesia? Clearly, if they transfer, this is an indication that they know that kahit na may jurisdiction sila, there will be no more execution because we hold the physical custody. So that's another thing that perhaps internally within Indonesian society, of course, there are those who support Mary Jane. There are human rights organizations within Indonesia who are supportive of her, but there are, again, also hardliners. For hardliners, they will know that Indonesia is not surrendering its jurisdiction over the case, but that they already are conceding that there will be no execution. And that's still a major concession. Kaya nagpapasalamat ulit tayo sa Indonesia. Terima kasih, Indonesia.
Yusek, habol ko na lang isa. Kasi kanina sa interview kay Tatay Cesar Veloso ni Alan Francisco ng PTV, ang sabi ni Mang Cesar, hindi pa daw yata alam ni Mary Jane yung magandang balita.
Ang pagkaintindi ko, hindi pa rin niya alam.
Okay.
Bakit hindi niya alam? Kasi hindi pa final yung details eh. Yes, Obam.
All right. We go back to Pia Gutierrez, and we're about to end the press briefing.
Sir, clarify lang yung tungkol sa clemency. Once she's transferred here in the Philippines, sino magbibigay ng clemency? Would it be President Marcos or President Prabowo?
That is to be discussed. But in the talks with Ambassador Pamoralin, they were open to the possible eventual grant of clemency by our own president. There are two options. We will request while she's here for the official release from detention from the Indonesian criminal procedure system, or another one, they will allow our president to issue the clemency on the basis that she's been in detention for many years, she was a victim, as we say, there's this case happening in Nueva Ecija. That is not yet final. Of course, that would be an incredible bonus as well. It's already great that they're transferring her, but that is certainly possible, that it will be a president issuing clemency. But before, Indonesia's listening to us, before we talk about it, we again respect Indonesia's sovereignty and jurisdiction over this case. We will not do anything which will be against their will or much less against their own laws. But they are open.
Follow-up lang po. In case po na hindi si President Marcos, will we initiate requests for President Prabowo for clemency?
Tatagalogin ko po. I think araw-araw nag-initiate tayo. No? Hindi, when I say that, I don't mean literally araw-araw. Pero alam na ng Indonesia that we always raise this, always. And now, mayroon pang bagong presidente, bagong pangulo ang Indonesia, a good friend of our president. Certainly, we will initiate it as soon as possible. And nabanggit na gusto ng family mapalaya na right away. So obviously, we can't do it within 24 hours nang dumating siya dito. But, well, hopefully, we don't have to, I mentioned kanya, we don't have to wait years or even like 1 year paano, bago mapalaya siya. We will certainly initiate it.
Okay. Sam Adenilio, final question.
For Sir Clavano na lang po. I-clarify lang namin, sir, kung kailan po niyo expected ma-complete yung negotiation dun sa terms ng pag-returning.
I cannot say that, but it seems that Indonesia wants it, we want it, but Indonesia wants this resolved as soon as possible. So I certainly hope that won't take up to next year. But ito naman ang request namin. It would help if the media and the public would just allow DFA and DOJ to do our work. Kasi baka maging sensitive ang Indonesia na everyday lumalabas sa dyaryo natin, ano yung stage ng talks, parang yung basis extension agreement. Parang, no, let's just allow us to do the work, allow the president to do his work, and then ang maganda, we'll just announce na ayos na. Di ba, Asek, what do you think?
Yes, well, these are things that are very sensitive, especially when you're talking about the difference in laws, the mechanics of the transfer. Kaya po, tama po yung panawagan ho ni Yusek De Vega na sana ho in the next few days, weeks, or hopefully that hindi na umabot ng months, baka pag-announce na ho kami na pauwi na talaga si Mary Jane Veloso.
Just let us talk to them. Kasi pag i-announce yung kunyari ganito, mamayang konti may sabihin, ay mali yun, mali yun. Yeah. Basta importante, makarating na siya rito.
Okay, thank you so much, Malacanang Press Corps. Thank you, Undersecretary De Vega and Assistant Secretary Clavano. Again, in the words of President Marcos, we are looking forward to welcoming Mary Jane home. Okay, this concludes our press briefing. Thank you.